John Emerald is my grandfather's first and middle name, and we named the business after him because family was the catalyst to open the business in the first place. My daughter being born made it where I didn't want to be on the road anymore, so we decided to pull the trigger on opening this, which was something we wanted to do for a long time. And since family was the reason, we looked to family to name the business as well.
We had to go out of state to legal distilleries to actually learn, and there's plenty of schools out there. You know, you can go to whiskey school, you can go to rum school, and we did that. We went to whiskey and rum school, and also Jimmy went to Scotland and did an internship with Springbank Distillery over there. So we went to Chicago for a technical distilling course at Siebel Institute up there. So there's plenty of education out there if you want to get it.
In the same way you make beer, you take grain, you mill it, you mash it, you let it, you get all the sugars out of it, and then you ferment those sugars by adding yeast. You get it to about 9% alcohol, then you put it in a still, and the still removes the alcohol out and flavor as well, and it concentrates it into a higher alcohol spirit. And then after that, you process it, and like we, in terms of our rum, we make one kind of rum off the still, and that's a silver rum. And then let's say we're going to make spice rum. Then we take it and put it into a vat. We add the spices. It sits and soaks with the spices for about a week and a half, and depending on the proof of the alcohol. And then when it tastes right, we pull it off, we filter it, bottle it, and it's spiced rum. And other products go into a barrel for a period of time. And so, and the category of Alabama whiskey is really not been filled. No one's filled in the blank on that. And you know, there's Tennessee whiskey, there's Kentucky whiskey, and so why not? So we're one of our endeavors is to fill in the blank of Alabama whiskey.